University, I think, or whatever it is, the one in the north side. Now they're graduating college, and I knew them when they were little. It just, time flies by.
It does fly by.
But Daniel's art, I always watched when he was younger. He had a big drawing pad. He'd just sit there with nothing else to do, do three-dimensional pictures. The picture would be so good. It looked like you'd stick your hand into the portrait and feel people, that face and everything. And it was that good. Even though, so I know he can handle drawing the pictures we see, stuff we see in our mind. That's what we want to do. Maybe that could be a fundraiser for us. We could auction off pictures, you know. Go ahead. Sorry. Jeremy has to get a phone call real quick. Maybe we could always do that. If people, we could have had some nice paintings done, and maybe if we needed a fundraising for our healing groups or anything to help, you know, maybe we could get some beautiful pictures auctioned off, you know, put them online so you can see what they look like. Just an idea. But we're here to help, and I can't, you know, I can't count how many times I've said that on these videos, but I feel like I should say it again, that y'all just need to write the call without fear, without feeling shy or embarrassed or feeling like you're wrong for doing it. You know, you're fine. Call us. Call us about it, you know, and we're going to help, you know. And, of course, we might not be able to get back to you that very day. It might give us a day, you know, sometimes it may be a minute. We have a lot of work going on, lots of calls, you know, but we will get to you. Just please be patient, you know. Just please be patient, and we will work with you, you know. And we'll do the best we can. And we wanted to say, I want to say personally that I really appreciate the word of mouth referrals that many people have done. It's much appreciated. Please keep doing that. I mean, if you're happy with how things were done for you, or if you're happy with us, let people know about it, because we want to help as many people as possible. You notice it's not about money, as you all know, we don't charge anybody a dime. We live hand and mouth kind of here, you know, whatever. We trust the universe. Jerry said that it's almost like we live like Buddhist monks and Hindu monks do in Asia and Eastern countries. And you just wander the streets and just wander around. And you just basically, we count on the universe to take care of us. For, you know, we might not be living in the woods right now, you know, like a monk would be, like an ascetic would be. But, you know, I can tell you that Jeremy and I have had past lives where we did that. You know, I'm aware of many of my past lives. I've opened up and been able to see many of them. And my past lives go back billions of years, billions of years. You know, I have memories from billions of years ago popping up sometimes. You know, and it sure wasn't on Earth. I was living in another dimension sometimes, and I lived in other galaxies. Hundreds of thousands, millions of light years away, some of them from this earth. You know, and believe it if you want to, or if you think I'm lying, go ahead and think that, but I can assure you, I'm telling the truth of that. I don't lie about anything. You know, this is what's going on. You know, I don't remember all my past lives, but I remember significant ones. You know, and you have past lives like that too. A lot of y'all aren't able to remember it right now, but you have the ability to. And all of you have lives going back billions of years, just like we do. You know, we just happen to remember ours a little better. You know?
Yeah, we're talking about past lives.
Past lives, yeah.
Yeah, I understand. Yeah.
I posted about it today, actually. There's a post, if you look for it, like it's buried under the comment under another post. But I talked about some of my extraterrestrial lives, you know, being the commander of some kind of time ship or dimensional ship, that our job was to manipulate people's history and other planets, change events and observe things.
Yeah.
And but yet, I ended up killing my crew in that lifetime. This is about, I think about 20 million years ago, 10, 15, 20 million years ago, this life. For some reason, I killed off my whole crew one by one. I had big black eyes, one of those type aliens, but I had long blonde hair still. You know, I wasn't quite the gray alien you see on TV, but tall and skinny, long hair.
Yeah.
You know, and I was a commander. Some reason I killed my crew.
Yeah.
And then that's the last alien life I remember, because I think I was banished here. That's what I'm getting at, that, like, my soul got dumped into this realm, this dimension, this earth, into the reincarnation cycle here.
Yeah.
I think that's what happened for punishment. That was my punishment, to be dumped here.
Dumped here. With this life, yeah.
And had been being, the earth is a prison. Let me speak on that. We could do a whole video on that, but this earth is a prison plant. Let me be forthright. You know, you might not have bars around you like certain humans do, but you are in a prison. We've all been banished here. All of us are either here, or younger souls that have been created and put here, or extraterrestrial souls that have been banished here, or chose to come here.
Yeah, I mean, you know,
we chose to come here too,
yeah.
But we were banished in the same way from another culture.
Because this culture is so much about, you know, human conditioning. You know, you gotta believe this, you gotta believe that, you gotta do this, you gotta do that, and it's the right thing to do. When really, you know, you gotta go what's in your heart for what's the right thing to do, not necessarily what other people tell you the right thing to do is.
Yeah, that's a big lesson you can learn, because once you once you get past that, caring what other people think, and you start doing positive things, instead of negative things, not worrying about others' opinions, you've achieved a major learning lesson, and you're that much closer to ending your reincarnation cycles in this world. You're that much closer to freeing yourself from the chains bonding you.
Yeah.
You know, you've basically got chains holding you down. Jeremy and I have mentioned before, we're on our last physical life here. This is our last one. Out of billions of years of physical lives, we've reached the last one. And the chains have been broken. We're going to be broken completely off. You know, and then after this, we live non-physical lives. That's all we're going to be doing. We're going to be staying non-physical.
Yeah,
you know, we progress to another level, non-physical. You know, we can come back if we want to, if we want to bounce back in for a life or two here and there. But I'm not sure. I don't think I will, unless it's on another planet. I will consider living in some extraterrestrial lives in a highly advanced culture in the world. I would consider living that. Well, we have done that before.
Yeah,
we've lived like that.
Yeah, it's hard to remember, of course, everything.
I remember a few vivid details of some of those lies.
Yeah, some of the...
We were spiritual teachers, even, in those worlds.
Some of
we talked to you.
Some of the things that we've seen together, you know, the planets and things that we weren't, you know, like, talking about before, we see exactly the same.
Same thing, you know. That's how we know it's true. You know, we didn't have to talk about it, but it's all there. We see, remember ourselves. We see ourselves living those lives, and we see what we look like, and... And we see ourselves teaching youth. You're teaching alien youth about spiritual mastery and a lot of those lies. We were high-ranking people, one of some of the most high-ranked people in the world, you know, because we taught the future generations. We were instructing. Our job was to pass knowledge to the youth, to the next generation. Let me check this. What time is it on there?
We got to wrap it up in 2 minutes.
What time is it?
It's 18:51.
We got 1 minute left here. We have a friend of ours named Mike here today with us. We're going to interview him next time. He's going to sit with us probably tomorrow. He's sitting behind the camera today. He's a little tired from work. Good dude. You know, you'll like him. You know, he's on his own spiritual path of his own. He's learning too. So I guess we're going to close this one up and get back to part two in just a minute.
Yeah.
And
I hope this video helps. Peace, y'all. One love.